Welcome to the Rope Access channel, where we talk and teach all things rope access. In the coming months, I will teach you all the knowledge and skills required to get you going on all different levels in the rope access industry. I will start with the basics and gradually move up in skill. So, what is that going to look like? For the first few months, I will release 3 videos per week until the basic rope access library is finished. After that, we move into phase 2 of the channel, which I will announce around the summer of 2022. Each video will build on the knowledge of the video before. Some of the things we cover are all the gear we need to start climbing, how to go up and down a rope, what to do when you find a damaged spot in the rope, and how to transfer to a new set of ropes. You will learn how to climb underneath a platform using various techniques and how to pass an edge for when you're coming off the side of a building. We will get into basic rigging and move on to advanced rigging, where we combine multiple different anchor points to share the load. That knowledge can and will eventually evolve into the advanced skills of hauling and lowering systems and tensioning lines and using those to move a load or a casualty. Speaking of casualties, of course we will get into rescues as well. Again, starting at the basic level 1 descending rescue, where you come from your own set of ropes to rescue the casualty, and move into the more advanced level 2 and level 3 rescue exercises. So if you're interested in all this, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell to be notified as soon as I release a new video. And give this video a thumbs up. Also, please leave a comment on what you would like to see discussed in the next video. Maybe it's a technique or a certain piece of gear or a philosophy on rope access techniques. The long-term goal of the Rope Access channel is to first and foremost create a complete video library of all the different rope access and rescue techniques out there. And second, a very important one to me, is opening up a conversation and enlarging the communal learning potential. If we have an open conversation on techniques and principles, we can all evolve into better rope access technicians. That means if you see me demonstrating something in a certain way or in a different way than what you were taught, let me know in the comments and let's get a conversation going. Maybe we find out that your way is a better way or that my method is just another method. Either way, we all learn. Now, the rope access industry is an interesting one for a multitude of reasons. For one, you get to travel the world and work on all kinds of crazy projects, which all provide their unique challenges. Second, there are a lot of opinions on how something should be done. But the thing is, there is no one way of doing something. If you scale everything back into the essential principles, the discussion about the method is sort of moot. We need to accept that. People are different, and an explanation that makes sense to me might be confusing to you. Therefore, for some exercises, I will show you a few different ways to accomplish the task. My philosophy is that you need to understand the principles of a given task. If you do that, then you can create your own methods. The principles are built up of doing something within a certain set of constraints. And if you adhere to these constraints, you will always perform the task safely. For instance, the objective of performing a successful rescue from ascenders and passing a deviation is a byproduct of doing everything within the constraints of staying on 2 points of contact and preventing uncontrolled swings. This is just to give you an idea on what I mean. There are more constraints within that scenario, but if you just use a method without understanding the why, then when the situation is slightly different, for instance, you move from left to right instead of right to left, you might end up on 1 point of attachment. As I'm based in the Netherlands, some of what I teach might be according to Dutch rules and regulations and not applicable to your location. So take care to always be informed wherever you are working of the local laws and regulations and also company policies. There is a difference between what you get taught indoors and out there in the practical world. Sometimes you just need to get the job done. Safely, of course, but maybe not up to training standards. Best example that comes to mind is positioning yourself statically on an open beam or on an edge while you rig your ropes. Officially not allowed, and forces generated should be really low, if you understand the principles. And they should be so low that a shoelace would suffice. So an open beam is good enough in that moment. So, please be respectful in the comments when you get into a discussion with a guy who only works out there in the oil rigs or in the geo industry versus someone whose main focus is training and indoors and working in the perfect scenario and the perfect environment, right? Be respectful to each other. One final note, and this is important. These videos, as good as they might be, they do not replace proper in-person training. However, they can certainly serve as a support method of proper training. If you want to see what you need to know as a rope access technician or when you're coming up towards your reassessment, you can have a look and refresh your mind. All right, guys, let's dive in. I'm excited. Stay connected.